Boom.
And okay, we got it another two, guys. This is the other IMSI. This is also the other IMSI as well. Hello, welcome to Rifki the Cyber. Today, I'm going to share it to you the passive 4G IMSI catcher. Yes, you are not wrong to hear this one. A 4G passive IMSI catcher. The knowledge are dynamics. If you asking me the 4G passive IMSI catcher, if this is real work, I'm going to tell you in the 4 months ago or 5 months ago, I'm going to say this is not possible. But it turned out this is possible with the valid explanations based on the standard telecommunications. If you want to know what is the IMSI catcher, if you are the new audience, look at my other video. Those passive IMSI catcher in that video is actually for the 2G. But today I'm going to explain it to you for 4G. I'm not pranks. This is real work. We harvesting directly from the air of the networks in this case. How come this is possible? I'm going to explain it to you based on the telecommunication standard in the end of this video. What is the device that I'm going to use? I'm going to use my own mobile phone with the Qualcomm chipset rooted Android in this case. I'm using the Redmi Note 7 in this case. Almost all the comments are the same with the previous video about the real-time call tracing. Same, but later we just need some improvement, not in the comment, but some preparations in the Wireshark itself. We will using the Wireshark. And the IMSI that I'm going to catch is not my IMSI or my laboratory IMSI here. This is the real IMSI, the real-life IMSI that exists in the networks. So this is not pranks. This is not dummy or simulate everything from my own, for example, on my own laboratory for active. No, this is actual IMSI catcher from others existing valid subscribers. You are going to see it. No worries, guys. And because I want to get the IMSI as much as I can, what I'm going to do is I'm going to the mall and I'm going to the food courts so we can find some IMSI from that one. Maybe you were wondering how this is possible. This is possible if you are using the rooted. But Rifki, the frequencies will be bonded with the SIM card. Well, as of now, I'm just going to say yes. But actually, there is a method how to tune the frequency or the gr-gsm from this mobile phone. But I'm not going to explain in this video. So guys, let's go to the mall. I'm going to pack my bag in this case and see you there. And after that, we will back here with some explanation from the standard telecommunications. Guys, don't forget to subscribe, switch on the bell, like, and share this channel to others. Okay, the first thing is, I will not explain to you the details of my other two comments. So my other two comments is usually, I will run like this. You can see it from my other video about how to I'm running the real-time call tracing. I will put it the link in the descriptions of this video, or you can see in the cards of my video. But I will just give you the hints if you want to see it. I will just spill it for you when one of the comment is like this. So if you see from here, so I will run like this, the QC Super. You can see it my real-time call tracings, right, in my other previous video. I'm just running this comment. I will not explain it to you one by one. I will just run like this. Okay, logging switch is already on. Enable logging, that means already on. And then I'm going to running like this. So this is my mail, my mall.pickup. So we'll see from here. Okay guys, after some times you already see there are so many traffic here. Then what we're gonna do next is we just need to filter this one. RRCU identity 1. If 0 is TIMSI, if 1 is IMSI. So we just put like this. Aha! We already got several IMSIs from here. If you see, I'm doing my setup. I was just running it before. So sometimes it's not really fast. There are some, like for example, 50 seconds until 1 minute or 3 minutes in this case. So what I'm gonna do, you cannot see the IMSI here. It's very simple. Actually, the IMSI is located here. In this example, I will just expand all. And then after that, I'm going to make this as a column, apply as a column. And then boom, this is the IMSI. He is located here. Okay, I will just shift the IMSI in the other column. It's simple, just dragging like this. Okay, so you can see right now there are some IMSIs here. Even we can see there are some IMSI from another country in here, in this case, guys. So this is how you can do it. And you see here there are some different, for example, even the other from the other one, it's like 30 seconds. And okay, we got it, another two, guys. This is the other IMSI. This is also the other IMSI as well. We can see from here. So actually, this is really real. The IMSI catching, we got it from the 4G networks in this case. So I think that's very clear for you. If you want to see the other previous comment in the details, you just need to check my other's video about the real-time call tracing in this case. So guys, if you want to donate the channel by click the link of the buy me coffee here, or you want to treat me the coffee, 1 cup, 2 cups, 3 cups, 5 cups, 100 cups, I'm so happy. I will just put it the QR code around here. So how come this is possible? Based on the 3GPP standard TS24.301 in the clause 56222, there is an abnormal procedure when the networks is not capable to fetch the TIMC itself, or maybe the tracker area indicator is not in the list, so the network will paging with the IMSI itself. Maybe you can conclude, for example, Rifki, if we see a lot of IMSI that in this case, that mean this operator have a lot of abnormal procedure due to some failed IMSI. You can conclude that one. But basically, it's not all the same operator will have the same network failure, right? Some of them we can harvesting more IMSI, some of them is we can harvesting a little fewer IMSIs in this case. So I think that explanation is really valid. So this is justify why we get those IMSIs. And as I always say in my other previous video, keep learning and stay humble.